Hey, what's up, guys? This is Ryan, SR2264, back again with another video for you guys, and today, I am here talking about the Lego set Trouble on Tatooine, set number 75299, and this set is, in my opinion, one of my personal favorite Lego sets, for the minifigures. Everything else is just kind of okay, so the first and most obvious thing, the reason people are buying this Lego set is the Mandalorian. And some weirdos are buying it for the little creature over there. I really wanted this Lego set, particularly for the Mandalorian himself. And I know my flash just disagrees with me, so I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to break out another light to show you guys all the awesome detailing. So first things first, here is his ambient rifle and his pistol. They look quite nice, and luckily the set comes with enough little spare bricks you can build another little ambient rifle, which I changed up the design just a smidge. But anyways, this is the Mandalorian himself in his full Beskar armor. Look how awesome that is. Just all the detail that exists. And this minifigure is, in my opinion, one of the best detailed. And as you can see, he has shoulder detailing, and my camera just dislikes me right now. So let's see. Come on, let's get that focus going. There we go. As you can see, is the shoulder plate, and the whistling birds are right there. As you can see how the light is reflected. And then, there's his back printing. Anyways, here's his back printing. Pretty nice, pretty nice. And there's his right shoulder printing. And there's the shoulder printing, and as you can see, you have the mud horn right there. And the detailing is amazing. Anyways, moving on. So. Up next, as we can see, this is Baby Yoda. Baby Yoda. Baby Yoda. A.K.A. the child, A.K.A. Grogu. And it is tiny. It is so small. I thought, like, the astromech droids were tiny, but, like, it is a small little guy. I'm not gonna lie, it is kind of cute. I'm a little disappointed that there's no articulation in the arms, and the detailing is but you know what, for what it is, and for how small it is, I think it's worth it. Cute little thing. And his body is, or his head is a little rubbery. So, it's a softer plastic than something like the Mandalorian or any of the other Legos. So, yeah, definitely two of my favorite minifigures. If I had to rank some of my favorites, this would probably be number two, and this would be number one. But that's besides the point. So, the next minifigure is the Tusken Raider, or the Sand People Person. Yeah, it's called Tusken Raider on the box. And I like it. It's not unique to this set, but it's got some good back printing, good front printing. I like the head of it. I don't know why. It looks pretty good. And I like the weapon. It's a gaffy stick. And it is apparently a really badass weapon. I thought it was like just some junk lying around, but no, apparently it's a pretty cool weapon. So those are the three little minifigures you get. And as you can see, I really like the Mandalorian. His detailing is just amazing. And to me, I think this minifigure alone is worth the $30 price tag of the set. But let's check out the other things that the set came with. Alright, so the first build in this little Lego set that I've slightly modified so I could have the rifle right here in the backpack back there so you could see Baby Yoda, aka Grogu, in his little spot right there. So this is the little land speeder that was used by the Mandalorian, and Gotta say, I did not expect how this went together, because it was in pieces, obviously, but the pieces didn't look like they belonged to a speeder at all, and it came together really quickly, and you gotta, I'd say you get a decent speeder with this one. The Mandalorian doesn't sit very well in it, in my personal opinion, and there's some studs right there that don't do anything. I like how the backpack and Baby Yoda are in there. It's very interesting. It is a new, to me it's a new Lego piece. Let me show you guys real quick. That's what the piece looks like. And and to me it's brand new. I've never seen it before. And it wasn't on the TIE Fighter. So put that right there. So you have a little Baby Yoda sitting there, and has the Mandalorian flying along through the sands to hunt down the others of his kind, which he stumbles upon one. But anyways, I honestly think the speeder is the best part of the whole set. Oh, okay, maybe the best build of the whole set. The other two are kind of mediocre, to be honest, but this, it's okay. I wish it was more like a traditional speeder, and I wish the Mandalorian sat in there just a little better, but overall, it's an okay speeder. Alright, so this is the little sand hut that you can build. I personally don't really mind the gaps in it. I mean, the gaps are huge, I'm not gonna lie, but I personally don't mind. He had gaps like this on the Falcon, and I honestly didn't mind that. I mean, it is a small build, so I'm gonna keep that in mind. It would be cool if you could, if there was another piece to it. I guess you can buy a two, and you can have a full set, but it's kind of a neat little tent. You have the, you can have the spot for the Mandalorian, this Tusken Raider, and it opens up, so you can put them in there, and they can have a little chat. You got a little pot with a bone, and then you got a cup bowl right there. Then you got a little campfire, which I screwed up on and had to rebuild. Then you have a little spot for Grogu and stuff. My question is, what's up with this attachment? I don't remember. I have not the foggiest idea why that's there. Maybe to have another. And the bone just sits in the little pot thing right there. Yeah, it's okay. And they have this little tower right here in the middle. I don't know exactly what you would do with the little tower, but it's okay. I think that's all I really have to say, honestly. Is it's small, but you can get all the minifigs in there. And it's okay. Alright, onto the crossbow. Alright, so now for the final build, we have the little crossbow weapon that was used by the Sand People to take down the, it was used in the show to take down the crate dragon. I cannot believe it took me so long to remember that. But anyway, so this is the build. I'm going to move some of the minifigures out of the way. And this is it in its entirety. And I did, and there was an extra piece right there, so I just added the other bolt right there. So, and I'm not gonna lie, for what it is, it's actually a pretty nice sized crossbow, like for almost a person. Not so much for the minifigures. I mean, in the show, it's a lot smaller, and isn't very used much. And here, it's giant. It's got the giant bolt right there that you can fling and it shoots and stuff. And I like this a little more because it's a darker color. It's not like the bright reds or bright greens, so it kind of just camouflages in with the rest of the build with all the tans and browns colors. And there is a clear plastic brick on the bottom to give it some more stability, but I believe it can function without it, but it is more stable that way. And it's, the build itself is kind of static. You can't really move it very much. You have this little rotating piece, so it's like you're rotating it back. It's a pull the back the bow, you know, the strings, and then you fire it into some stormtroopers or something. Like this. Hand over Baby Yoda. Heck no. Heh, you missed. So, overall, I enjoyed this set, I enjoyed the price point, and I do like the three little builds it comes with. And I love the printing on the Lego Mandalorian, and I love the fact that it does also include Baby Yoda. There's just a handful of things I would have rather them tweaked. And I think they should have added the guy wearing Boba Fett's armor, or instead of having the little hut, they should have included like a mini crate dragon or something. Because these two are supposed to be teamed up, so it's not like they're trying to shoot at each other. Like how the box depicts. But anyways, guys, I would highly recommend getting this set. I found my copy at Target, but I believe they also sell them on Amazon and probably at Walmart. Anyways, guys, this is RanSR2264. Signing out, my amigos. Peace! Have a fantastic day today. And late happy birthday to myself, I guess. Peace!